Well, this building that you can see in the background is a 10 by 10 building, and I've got a 3,000 gallon water tank in that building. Now, I could have gone to a variable cistern. I found one that was about 3,500 gallons, but it was ranging between $10,000 and $12,000, plus all the installation, you know, the excavation and concrete for the base and all that. So I decided to go this direction. I think I can come in at about half that price. So anyway, what I need to do is put insulation around that tank to try to keep the water flowing through the wintertime. You know, we can get 20, 30s below kind of regular. There's times that we touch 40, and I've even been in 50 plus below, but that's not a normal. But you kind of have to plan for that anyway. You know, I could dig a well, but it's about a $100,000 deal to drill a well because we're about 1,500 feet. And then you get into a methane gas belt. So right in this area here, the water really isn't any good except for maybe cows, without doing an RO system to filter it and all that. So that's kind of where we're at out here. And I came into this with my eyes wide open and kind of planned to do this an off-grid type of deal. So that's what I'm going to do today is start insulating around this water tank inside this 10 by 10 building. Yeah, this is probably about half what I need, but it'll get me started. I got another bundle of 12 in here that I'll haul up. But I'll take this up and kind of see how it gets started and see how it goes. So this is our tank here inside. So you can see this is our 2x4 walls, pretty good sized tank. You know, it's pretty tall. It's much taller than our door. I think it's an 8 foot tall tank. I'm not going to be able to get my 4x8 sheets up in over the sea, over the top of this tank. So what I'm anticipating, I'm going to cut a door, access door here on this gable end, hinge it, you know, I'll put this trim around it and all that to seal it back up. But as I get in really close on the sides, I may not be able to get around. I may have to take my styrofoam in through the top and then slide it down along the sides. I don't really know till I try to get in there and kind of figure this out. But that'll also allow me to get my styrofoam in on the top. And I may just fill that up with batting. I thought about putting in blown in, but blown in insulation has just over slightly 2 R value per inch, where the styrofoam is 5. So I want as much R value in here as I can, again, trying to beat the cold for the winter. And I'll bank up around the side, and I'll plumb out, and I'm gonna bury down 6 feet. That's what I'm trying to get this backhoe running for. I'm going to trench out here and drop down 6 feet. Well, on that 6 foot drop, I bought a heat tape that'll run off of a 12 volt battery, since we don't have 110 electricity out here. So I'm going to run it off of a 12 volt battery. I'm going to wrap that pipe. So that will, hopefully by default, that heat will rise back up and actually add a little bit of heat into the tank, and the R value will help sustain that, try to keep this tank open. Plus we need to be 6 feet deep for frost level to keep the pipe thawed out when we run downhill gravity feed. Again, trying to work without electricity. So that's the goal, but today, and I'm gonna put in this batting, and I don't think I'm going to be able to show you why I'm in here, because it's pretty close quarters and actually it's pretty dark. I have a tough time seeing, so I don't think you're going to be able to see on the camera. So there's going to be kind of a time lapse here. I'm going to do some of this insulation, and then maybe I'll show you what I can of what it looks like once I get it in. So I'll start hauling some batting over anyway. I don't think this one's going to be quite tall enough, so I brought my 16 to get up on top. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to shimmy around the back. I'm going to shove this tank into this corner to open up the right side and the back side so I can get in and navigate it. And then I'll shift it over to this corner to where I can put the side in. And I may have to have a door in here before I can get to the ceiling. We'll kind of see how it goes. I'm going to shove this tank over anyway. Not sure how much you'll see of this. It's pretty movable at this point. That'll kind of allow me to get in to the side wall and the back wall. I don't pin myself in here. I got some company. There's two calves showing up to see what's going on. Kind of a Curious George type of deal. Well, I've got this side. This would be the west side and the south side. I've got the batting in that. I've got some 2-inch styrofoam here in the pickup. It's 4x8 sheets that I brought up. I'm going to try to put this inside around that tank. I did stick one in already to see if it's going to go, and if I go in on the horizontal, then I can rotate it up and then circle it around that tank. I'll show you what I've got inside. Hopefully you can kind of see some of this as it'll go in. I do have a squeeze in the door. So this would be the southwest corner. This is the south side going around the back of the tank. So you see, I did fit one sheet in, and what I'd like to do is do 3 layers thick. That's going to give me an R30, and then the R15 that's in the wall will give me an R45 total on the wall. And then up in the ceiling, or attic, or roof, whatever it's called, I have quite a little bit of height. I'm not quite sure what I'm going to do there. Get this up where maybe you can see a little bit what I'm dealing with, but I'll end up maybe filling out the corners and just laying this full of batting. That's yet to be seen, just what I'm going to do. So my plan, you know, plans are plans, whether it really works out or not, but I want to put 3 deep on the back side, the south side, and 3 deep on the west side, on the side here. Then I'm going to swing the tank over, and these outlets I'd like to be over past the door where I can still get to them. Shove it over, then hopefully I can get enough room to get in and finish the batting and do the opposite, hopefully slide those in. If I can't get that done, I'm going to go ahead and cut an opening in the face here, and I can slide them in on the top and then fish them down. So one way or another, that's kind of the plan to try to get this done. I'm going to go part way, then I need to be able to rotate it up here. So to fill in the corner, I need 14.5 inches. These are scored at 16, but I don't want 16, I want 14.5. Those of you who do this all the time probably get a chuckle. There you go. Well, I have my 3 inches from the studs out, and I actually have, that gives me 6 inches, but I actually have 7 inches from the studs out to make it the tank center into the building. So I did have some 1 inch of this styrofoam that will take up that extra inch. So I'm going to put it on the back and the side, and then I'll be completely tight from the tank to the insulation, and that'll give me 30, 45, that'll actually give me a R50 on the walls to the tank. Cows are moving out to pasture. Well, I've been at this a good part of the day. We're 5:30-ish or so in the afternoon. I kind of feel like I'm painting myself in a corner. As I fill in these walls, things keep closing in. So I've got my 50 R value in the back. I ended up putting this strap around because before I could get in and kind of push it around, where now I can't get in there. So I needed something that I could grab a hold of and kind of shift this tank a little bit better. So once I get it in place and everything's tight, I think I can slip this loose and slide it out. We're kind of hoping, otherwise it'll live there. But I think I can get it out. I'm going to shift it back to the east side, the left side here, and finish putting in some styrofoam on the west side, the right side. Then shift it over and you kind of do that. Once I get the two sides in the back, then I can just slide in the sides and I think I can kind of finish that up. I still haven't cut a hole in the top yet. Still need to do that. So this will give me good access to the top. I can fill in these corners. Now I'll go ahead and I'm going to put two layers of R38 in here, so I'm going to have a 76 R value over the top of this tank. So what I've got so far is I put 2 4-foot pieces vertically down the corners between the styrofoam and the tank that filled up that void. Similar to what I have still in this corner, this is where the plumbing is going to be, so I haven't filled that one up yet. So I have 2 layers over the top of the tank, and then I have a 3rd layer over that, over this kind of a hip roof barn style. I'll go ahead and top this off and bring it all out. I'm actually going to be at an R114. I'll be well over 100 anyway. That ought to help winterize this tank. You know, I've had this building with the water tank in it for about a year and a half now, and I've been thinking, yeah, I'll get around to kind of trenching this in. Well, my round two, it kind of showed up. With these two calves we've got here, I've got to get this in before winter sets in. So that's kind of my push to get this insulated and eventually trenched down to a frost-free hydrant where I can keep them watered through the winter. So this is one step in that process. Appreciate you following along. Thanks for watching.